bench for City this evening. Our referee is Simon Hooper. Chris Kavanagh, our VAR official, as we get underway, and City attacking the north stand, playing from right to left, get us underway. And immediately Haaland gets a flick on there. Gross in at right back, as it's expected, chased down by Foden. But the German decides to put it to halfway, and Rodri heads it across to Kyle Walker, sweeps it back to Ortega on the edge of his own box. And Ciso to try and press. Short ball into Bernardo Silva. Now Gundogan. Good tackle there by Van Hecker, who's come forward deep into the City half. We saw that against Newcastle as well. And now Silva has it for Gundogan again. Just shifting it across to the right-hand side. And John Stones, been a bit of a makeshift midfielder of late as well. Former Barnsley player has it on his near side. Gundogan sliding it back to Stones again. Well, Van Hecker's playing in this sort of midfield role with Albion with three at the back just at the moment, just trying to stop City from coming.
Man-to-man system, Johnny, isn't it?
Yeah.
What they play.
Trying to get on Silva, do you think?
Well, yeah.
Or maybe even De Bruyne. I think it's Caicedo's trying to get the man to mark De Bruyne. Here is Caicedo.
It's a four at the back anyway. Lewis is playing left back. Walker's playing right back. Rodri and Stones.
Yeah, so. Rico Lewis can play in midfield, in at left back at the moment. Steele from the edge of his own box, trying to find Mitoma, who's coming off the left flank. Cross comes Walker, so much pace, but did he foul Mitoma? Yes, as the referee. Good pace there from Mitoma, coming across, tracking with Walker.
It's good pace, isn't it? But I think a bit too casual from Walker, wasn't it? Didn't know Mitoma was going to follow him, ended up giving a free kick away, but they're not at it, we'll pick them off. It's down to us, isn't it?
Free kick there, midway through the City half, just to the right of centre. Pascal Gross, the captain this evening, prepares to take it. Bunched up over on the left-hand side, Cole and Van Hecker are forward. The line is about 4 yards outside the box for City. Gross taking his time. Cole certainly trying to get past Walker, who's marking him, but pushing and shoving there, and it's angled towards Colwill now, who leaps, and there is a header from Walker, and it goes to the far side, where it's picked up by Bernardo Silva. Levi Colwill named in the England under-21 squad today, as was Carl Rushworth. Congratulations to him. That squad will be trimmed down a little bit. Rico Lewis managed to get there before Billy Gilmore, to the left of Foden, now back to Rodrigo. Cross there to near side, Albion pressing, but Bernardo Silva picking it up. A few yards of space, little short pass to De Bruyne, tracked by Van Hecker. Van Hecker slides in, and it's a free kick.
Well, they're moving the ball very well, aren't they, Man City? That's for sure. When the man Silva coming deep, picking it up, De Bruyne's trying to get on it.
Curled into the middle, Van Hecker cuts it out on his chest to Gross. Gross back to Steele. Steele controls it with his left foot, then drags it with his right onto the 6 yard box. No one pressing him at the moment. Taking his time now. Fires it forward to Buenanotte, but Rodri manages it to head it into the Albion half. Now Foden with the second ball. Van Hecker beats De Bruyne to that one. Buenanotte up against Rico Lewis. Thought it had gone out of play, it had. And it'll be a throw to Manchester City. Buenanotte is going to work hard and stay goal side of this man on this right hand flank.
He's gone off to help out. Passive goals defending as well, isn't it? Because Foden's quick, Lewis is quick. So they get beyond. They want to make two against one situation, isn't it, Man City, all over the pitch?
Yeah, they certainly do. Former Seagull striker Warren Ascoddle with us on BBC Radio Sussex. 4 minutes played, it's 0-0. The City have possession through Stones, who's taking it up the pitch. No one really halting him in his run there. Now Mitoma comes towards him, but doesn't manage to rob City of possession. And Mahrez comes into the central position in the centre circle. Now to Gundogan, just a little burst of pace to get forward 3 or 4 yards, then pushes it back to Stones. Along the ground to Lewis. Lewis in the centre of midfield here. It's all very fluid from City. Now De Bruyne, over to Walker. Walker powers in a high cross towards the back post, and Foden brings it under control neatly, then flicks it back. Silva with the curling shot, comes off Haaland, in there goes Foden again. Gilmore manages to scoop it clear. Now Buenanotte, away there from Mahrez, trying to send it across the pitch, cut out there by Walker. Run back by City.
I think it's an header for Haaland. If he goes with the head, it's a better chance of going with his jumping up, trying to volley it in.
Yeah, trying the old little cycle kick. Silva again, along the ground, square to Gundogan. He lays it off to Lewis. Lewis back to the captain, Gundogan, outside of the right boot, along the ground to the left-hand side. Silva to the edge of the box. Foden, turn, darting little run to get away from Gilmore. Onto his left foot, sticks it up back post. There's Haaland, and he's headed it over. The goal was gaping as well. It could have been Haaland's 37th Premier League goal of the season. It probably should have been his 37th Premier League goal of the season.
Absolute brilliant from Phil Foden. Can't get near him. Just drove between two players. Gets it back. So it's going to shoot, but it puts it back poles. It's 4 yards out. Free header. Sitter missed. From the best striker in the Premier League this season. Let off.
Yeah, it's a big let off. Been a huge blow to concede so early. Ended on by Buonanotte from a long clearance, but he falls to the ground and Rico Lewis goes to pick it up. Of course,
but the skill from Foden.
They need another. the control. Oh, well, the pitch looks wonderful, and I'm sure City will enjoy this Amex surface. So Albion need a point for the Europa League, and of course, bar a huge swing, it's 16 goal swing that would be required. And of course they play Aston Villa as well, so in effect you can double the goal difference if Albion were to lose. So hopefully we won't come to that, but maybe an early warning for the Seagulls not to concede early in this game, because we know what City can be like when they get the bit between their teeth, and they've got the big guns in the starting 11 as De Bruyne gets that back behind Rodri, who has to turn towards his own goal. Square pass to find Ortega, ball stuck under his feet, but easily bypasses Julio Enciso, who's yet to touch the ball in this game. Into the feet of Haaland, back to Gundogan, sweeps it over the top to Rico Lewis. Foden's unmarked on the left-hand side. Gross is backing off. This could be dangerous. Now Foden, ping it into the edge of the box. Haaland is there, but so is Van Hecker. Nice little drag back there. Clever play there by Van Hecker. Had to... A little ole is to Pascal Gross, does the old turn. And now he goes up towards Welbeck. His first touch comes bouncing off his knee, and City have possession again.
That's what we need to do. We need to make it stick. It's a great bit of play from the Brighton defenders, Van Hecker and Gross. The cross turns have heard of them. But then when you knock it to the strikers, they have to hold it up. Like you say, Enciso not touch the ball.
Bernardo Silva whacking the ball there. Straight into the face of Van Hecker.
I don't think so, John.
No?
No.
Is it a hand?
Yeah.
To be fair, if it hit me in the face from that range, I probably would be holding my face, so it probably was. Free kick, taken quickly by City. Here's Gundogan to the right-hand side. And John Stones into Lewis, over halfway to Gundogan. In there comes Mitoma, good tackle. Wins it, looks up, releases Buonanotte. Driving through the middle of the pitch, back to Mitoma again. Can Albion create something? Buonanotte once more, finds Welbeck on the angle, shoots! Oh, he scuffed his shot, and it came off Foden, out of play for a corner.
Great bit of play from Mitoma there, linking the play up. But little ball, Buonanotte, he gets Welbeck, but Welbeck takes an ace to get his shot away, doesn't he? Then he doesn't connect with it properly. These chances are not going to come along that often tonight. And you have to punish the City side there.
Corner then for the Seagulls. Great play by Buonanotte, teaming up with Mitoma. First corner of the game, and as for the home side. The short option is Gilmore, who's on the goal line, but Gross is going to take it. Van Hecker's in the middle, so is Colwill. Beyond them, towards Mitoma, easy header away for Stones. Gathered there by Caicedo, who forces Estupiñán a little bit wide. Right across the pitch there to Pascal Gross. Tried a first-time cross, and Rodri it is who mops up down by the goal line and gets it up there to Foden. Foden back into the left-back position. Lewis, Rodri, triangles in this left corner. Now Gilmore putting pressure on the man in possession. In there's Welbeck, scoops it onto the left foot of Gilmore. Shot saved by Ortega. Another good chance, two in quick succession for the Seagulls. But neither shot was convincing. Long clearance over the top, missed by Estupiñán. Picked up by Mahrez. Open start to the game. Mahrez onto his left foot, reverse ball. Walker arriving. Good tracking back there by Estupiñán. Good defending there. Certainly been exciting. Another chance this time for Gilmore.
It's a very good chance, Sonny. He's created the space himself, getting on his left foot. But again, didn't connect the ball with the ball properly.
Yeah, just want to get a good connection in those sorts of situations and really test Ortega. Made it very comfortable. And as you say, Warren, how many chances are they going to get in this game? 10 minutes gone, two there for the Seagulls. And Haaland, who's already had a header from 4 yards out over the bar, and he was unmarked, but it remains goalless here on BBC Radio Sussex. Penultimate game of the Premier League season for the Albion. As we head to Villa Park on Sunday. Villa, of course, looking to join the Seagulls in Europe. Late challenge by Caicedo. Good one it was who was fouled.
Fuming. Pet's fuming. Can read the ball quicker, look. Look at him.
Yeah, it's intensity. Yeah, fuming. Good noise from the Amex crowd. Some people saying, will this be the final home game for the likes of McAllister and Caicedo? Let's hope not.
Well, like I say, it's down to them now, isn't it? To hit the Europe target.
Yeah. And also, as Roberto Zerbi says, you go to the Europa League, it's another step up. Maybe it changes the situation in terms of their thoughts. Here's Ortega taking his time there. Oh, and Julio Enciso nearly managed to nick in there. He was in about four minds rather than two. City goalkeeper.
It's a small goalkeeper, isn't
it? It is, yeah. Again, he's good with his feet, isn't he? We bet we haven't seen much of him, have we? Because Edison's been playing week in, week out for the last few years. And here he is, chipping the ball up to Haaland. Haaland backing into Van Hecker, who wins the header. Good play there by Van Hecker. It's a loose pass. You get it to Enciso. They've got to be more careful. They've got to keep possession. As soon as you give it to City, you feel like you're under pressure, even if they have it inside their own half. Back they go to their keeper, Ortega, left-footed this time, drilling it into Haaland. Again, Van Hecker goes close to him, but they've offloaded it to the left. Bernardo Silva up the line to Foden. Foden running at Gross, waits, brings Silva into play, down the left side, 5 yards in from the touchline, into the middle. Lewis, now De Bruyne, sliding it across to Bernardo Silva, by the byline, rolls it back, Kevin De Bruyne now. Up against Gilmore, left-footed, crosses blocks, and Gundogan heads back to Rodri. Now to the right-hand side. Kyle Walker in possession now, just inside the Albion half. Now Rodri, more of a defensive midfielder, but playing on the left-hand side of the centre of defence. Strong challenge by Estupiñán now. Simon Hooper keeping his eye on that one. City still in possession inside their own half. Bernardo Silva.
What's this? They're moving the ball, just waiting for one lapse of concentration from the Brighton players. Then they'll play the forward ball, but at the moment just keeping the ball. I think they'll give you half a chance.
Well, they're certainly playing expansive football. It's pretty open. Do have a good record against the Albion. Won 10 out of their 11 encounters. Back past Ortega again. Is that a foul on Caicedo? No. Got a fair whack of the ball. Dangerous back pass. Buenanotti's gone down. Well, say, if anything, the keeper looks a little bit shaky.
Yeah, he does, yes. That's for sure. Well, I don't know what Buenanotti's done. I'm really honest.
But he tried to control it. He miscontrolled it. Then at full stretch. It's actually a block by Caicedo. What happened there to Buenanotte? It was on the near side, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think it was caught. I think it's seen double, I think. Buenanotte.
Well, certainly seen double with the way that Man City have played at times down this left-hand side with Silva and Foden darting around the pitch. But this is a concern for Buenanotte. So 14 minutes played. Goalless at the moment. And I'd say probably got more football than maybe expected with the injury to Jeremy Sarmiento, who we wish well. It's when De Bruyne's cross was deflected and it hit him right on the back of the head. And he's coming over to the near side.
Maybe bad treatment, you only have to come off, don't you?
So. Yeah. Just has a quick word there with Buenanotte. There's a quick discussion with the fourth official as well. Sure, Graham Scott. And play resumes with City in possession inside their own penalty area. Rodri across to the right to Stones. Julio Enciso trying to block off any angled balls. Now Mitoma goes in for the challenge, putting pressure there on Walker. Walker back to Stones. Stones launching it clear towards Haaland. He's grappling there with Colwill. Playing it back there. Van Hecker intervenes, hoists it over his shoulder. Could turn into a good pass that, as Welbeck scoops it up and plays it back there to Julio Enciso. Then he was blocked off the ball there as Welbeck tried to return it to the Paraguay international. And it'll be a free kick to the Albion.
Again, good pressure from Brighton. They won the ball back. Welbeck did brilliantly, held it up, and little one too with Enciso. Blocked off.
Yeah, Rodri it was, who just got his frame in the way and then just made sure that there was no way through. This is not a bad position. It's quite far out, but it's to the left of centre, probably say 15 yards outside the box. Can Albion conjure from this one? 16 minutes on the clock. Albion 0, Manchester City 0. Glorious evening. Will it be a glorious evening for the Seagulls as they prepare to take this free kick? Gundogan, De Bruyne, one other in the wall. It's a three-man wall. Gross is there, so is Estupiñán. Paul and Van Hecker on the edge of the box. It's from the left-hand side. It's a shot from Gross, and it's straight at the keeper. Again, didn't really get hold of it.
That's with some strike, though, wasn't it? From there. 30 yards out, 33, 34 yards out.
Yeah.
Had a grass cutter, didn't he?
Yeah. Maybe even hope for a little deflection or something. As it's launched upfield. Let's look on to Haaland. Haaland with his back to goal, trying to get away from the stooping yet. He does well. Now plays in Caicedo. Gilmore. Back to Van Hecker. De Zerbi. Marshalling his troops from the sidelines. Edging down the white line towards the north stand. Big whistle for Mitoma. Telling him to come off the flank. Off goes Steele. Drills it into Mitoma. First touch is a good one. Now he wants to take on Walker. Just took it out of play.
Yeah. To some extent, there's some ability to get past Walker, Johnny, after what I saw against Real Madrid.
Short past the edge of the box by Ortega. Bernardo Silva, very cool, very calm, getting it to Stones. Caicedo trying to press the England international. Up the pitch it goes. Colwill nudging it down the line. Oh, I think Walker thought he'd gone out of play, but it's a flick on from the cross by Julio Enciso, away by Lewis, now Welbeck. Oh, a late challenge there on Billy Gilmore by Gundogan. Free kick just outside the D.
Yeah, but Brighton, well, they're getting the bottom, aren't they? But impressive, making them make mistakes. They thought it was going to be easy, walk in the park. But it's not going to do that, are they, Brighton? Lie down and get beat on their own patch. Yeah, a bit of skill from Billy Gilmore, taking it away from Gundogan. Now this is a better opportunity, isn't it?
Just to the left of centre, about 6-7 yards outside the box. What are you thinking, Warren? Shot on target, surely?
Yeah, it's shot on target, that's for sure, but Welbeck's there. Cissé's there, Billy Gilmore's there, Stupian's there, Pascal Gross is there. So, after watching Billy Gilmore strike the ball in the first 5 minutes, and Welbeck didn't connect it very well, did you?
Well, it could be one of those three. Maybe Julio and Enciso will have a go.
I think it's Welbeck.
We've got somebody down in the old chaise long position, just on the ground, which is Bernardo Silva, so that daisy cutter probably isn't on. But Gross is going to go into the wall, so it's not going to be him. Maybe Julio and Enciso, perhaps.
I think it's Welbeck.
Well, maybe Estupiñán. It is at the left of centre, but
Lewis Cook's got a box behind the goal, hasn't he? He could hit it.
We shall see. Welbeck steps up over the wall. Oh, it's hit the top of the crossbar. Rebounds back. Van Hecker heads back into the box. Cleared by Manchester City.
Oh, unbelievable bit of skill from Danny Welbeck there. Oh, big let off for Man City.
Great effort, wasn't it? Can't do much more than that, Warren.
No.
He was dipping. Very nearly got on the underside of the bar, but it came back to the edge of the box. Oh, a loose pass there by Caicedo. Didn't find Buenanotti. Albion win it back. Looked like a foul there on Caicedo, not given by Simon Hooper in the build-up. Off goes De Bruyne, lays it off there to Haaland in the box, wants to get it onto his left foot, pulls it back. De Bruyne again, good tracking across the pitch by Facundo Buonanotte. He now looks up, steers it into trouble though as Rico Lewis gets there first. He then gives it away, Billy Gilmore up to Welbeck. Now Caicedo draws the foul, advantage played by the referee. Buonanotte back up on his feet. Left by Caicedo, Gilmore into Enciso, swept across there. Another foul from behind, no, says the referee. Gundogan it was, who seemed to come in from behind there, and it's played forward to Haaland. Haaland's away from Van Hecke, just got steel to beat, but it's a brilliant save by the Albion number one. Stood his ground, made the save, it remains 0-0.
If Haaland goes down there, John, it's a penalty, isn't it? He's stayed on his feet. That's a good save from Steele. Great touch from Haaland there. Takes away, then cuts across. There, he's trying to grab him. But great save. Great take from Haaland.
Albion up over the top. Welbeck, first touch is a good one. Goes to the left. Finds Mitoma, edge of the box. Trying to skip away from his man. Three in front of him now. Rolls it wide. Welbeck again, left corner of the box. Sends it infield. Short pass to Caicedo. Back to Mitoma. Shoots, and it's blocked. That's when they need to be careful here, because now suddenly De Bruyne are striding forward and up to halfway. Oh, it's been played at some tempo. We've only played a quarter of the game, Warren, but
what a chances
of huge intensity. Could have been 2-2, couldn't it?
Oh, yeah. Thought that it was down, that's for sure.
Yeah, good work by Jason Steele. We heard from him before kickoff. Wanting to end on a high, and he's done very well there, but City on the attack again through Foden. Foden getting to the edge of the box, running from left to right, pulling away from his marker, pulls it back there to Mahrez. Mahrez onto his left foot, shoots it flat. Good organisational play there by the Seagulls. Good challenge by Enciso, nodded forward back to him by Mitoma, lays it off. Mitoma up through the middle of the pitch, has he got the pace to get away? Plays it to the left hand side, off goes it Stupinian, but Walker is faster.
My word. What the pace is showed there, John. 70-30 in a Stupian's favour. And then just put the afterburners on and says, well, nobody's getting past me. Unbelievable pace, isn't it? We've seen it before this season. We saw it in the semi-final of the European Champions League. Sorry.
Midway points of the first half. Brighton and Hove Albion 0. Manchester City 0, live on BBC Radio Sussex Sport. What a season it's been for this team. And it's been another good performance so far in this game. Ortega just waiting for someone to come towards him. Now the keeper releases it. Straight up the pitch to Haaland, comes back off him. And there is Mahrez. Gundogan trying to find some width. Actually had five goal involvements away at the Albion, two goals and three assists, so he does like playing at the Amex Riyad Mahrez. He was stopped there. Here's Foden bursting through on the angle from left to right, forward to Bernardo Silva. His first touch is a poor one, back by Buonanotte to Gilmore jinking away from Haaland, taking it forward up into the left channel to Enciso, tried to just dink it past Stones had to slide in. It was a good tackle, but Albion with a throw.
You have to slow Foden down, Johnny, somehow. Can't just let him run in between players. But yeah, he has got a burst of pace, Foden.
I think he's playing some of his best football, isn't he? Yeah. He had a little bit of an injury, didn't it, which took him out for a period. One ball up to Mitoma. Missed there by Walker, but it will sail on through to Ortega, who goes out of his area to the right corner flag. Mitoma. What about challenging, but the big hoof up the pitch is headed forward there by Colwell. Now Stones to Rodri. Rodri now from deep to his captain Gundogan. Up it goes to halfway. Lay off by Haaland. He wants the return. He stayed onside. He threw on goal. Once again, he's only got Steele to beat. Onto that left foot of his. Steele's come to the edge of the box. Plays it across to Foden. Right footed. Oh, and Van Hecke couldn't clear off the line. He got a foot to it, but it's not enough to push it wide of the post. Foden has the goal, and City have the lead.
What a pass that was. Who's marking? Haaland. Wasn't expecting it, but that pass. I'm going to have to look at the replay because it's a wonderful pass. I think it's Mahrez. What's this for the pass? He knew he was going to, what he was making. Haaland unselfishly had to squirt it. Great from Steele. But then you, just the miskick on the touchline, is it, from Van Hecker?
Yeah. I think just frustrated, wasn't he?
Of course, that's just push up there, Johnny.
Yeah. He goes for the goal line, in fact, two Albion players, but someone needed to come close. I just think he was there, wasn't he? He was there to clear it. Yeah. I mean, Foden played it right-footed. He never really got hold of it, but Van Hecker...
Can't sort his feet out quick enough, Johnny, can he?
No. Five goals in five starts against the Albion now for Phil Foden.
Well, he started this game right up for it, hasn't he?
He has.
I think he's telling the manager, look, I want to play in that FA Cup final or Champions League final. He's up against it, Mahrez.
And that's the thing, isn't it, Warren?
You know, Grealish.
Really, Pep Guardiola could probably... And I think we know certain players who are going to play. There's probably four or five up for grabs, isn't there?
Oh, yeah, yes. That's for sure.
So, I've been trailing my goal to nil, and Ciso trying to turn it around the corner to Welbeck, but Rodri is there first and goes back to his keeper. How costly could those chances for Welbeck and Gilmore in the first 10 minutes be for the Seagulls? Maybe if they get comfortable, they may ease off, but it's been a really intense performance, well, from both sides early in this game. Albion now pushing with Caicedo trying to charge down the keeper. Gets it off there to Mahrez. Little flick header back from Haaland. Off goes Mahrez. Good body position by Estupiñán. Now Gross. Shout of man on because Foden was just behind him. I mean, Steele did very well to hold Haaland up, didn't he, Warren?
Yeah.
Giving it away again. And Rico Lewis at left back has it for City. I mean, it is relentless if you keep giving the ball away. But that's a good header by Gross to get Buenanotte on his way down the right. Rodri comes across. Buenanotte onto his left foot. Along the ground into Caicedo. The layoff is to Gilmore. Gilmore squeezes it to the left. Estupiñán chips it back in. It's found Buenanotte. Put it down his chest and it rolls into the keeper. What a chance that is as well. Just needed a perfect first touch, but it wasn't there. And immediately City try and attack through Gundogan. Back heel there to De Bruyne. De Bruyne. Haaland had made the early run, but De Bruyne just pushing it back there to Riyad Mahrez.
Benenoff is not expecting that to the back post, is he? From Estupiñán. It's a good cross. You have to be expecting it.
No.
Seen it late, tried to chest it, and it just bounced off his chest for the goalkeeper.
Difficult one to hit first time, isn't it, Warren? I don't think we can forgive him for trying to followed it up, but here's Haaland shrugging off Van Hecker. The layoff there is cut out by Mitoma. Now Gilmore slightly stretching to get that one, and Estupiñán plays it back to the keeper Steele. 27 and a half minutes gone, City leading by a goal to nil.
What they don't do, City, they don't press the goalkeeper, do they? They are pressed and they sit back.
No, but as soon as he releases it, that's when they go, isn't it? Then it's the slightest of mistakes. Steele chipping it to the left to find Mitoma straight out of play. Carl Walker doing a job there to just hold him up and allow it to go across his body and out for a Manchester City throw. 15 yards inside their own half. On the right for the visitors. Back goes to Ortega. Bright light orange kit for him today. Jason Steele in all yellow. Here's Rodri. To the left to Foden, first time ball to Rico Lewis, who's unmarked again. It's open at the back from the Albion, but this time Colwell gets into a good position to find possession. Mitoma now immediately loses it. Julio Enciso wins it back. Albion is still working hard. Welbeck, Caicedo, now to the right. Gross, still inside his own half. Early run by Enciso, wasn't a bad one, but here's Welbeck. Can he find Kaoru Mitoma? Delayed too long, couldn't get the pass away.
I think it was two good runs there. One from Enciso over the top. Mm. Pass was going to give it to him. Then Mitoma was on Welbeck. That's, I think, a little bit quicker. Especially when you're playing against these teams.
Certainly do. Here's Welbeck. A short pass to Enciso. Driving towards the edge of the box. Onto his right foot. It's deflected by Stones. And a play for a corner. Urged on by the Amex crowd as we head towards 30 minutes played in this first half. Yeah. Seagulls trailing by a goal to nil.
Enciso, not bad that. Then in the half turn, I like him when he does that. Drives at the City defence, gets his shot away. Blocked, gone for a corner, now it's in Paul. Can we score off a set play, John? can't we?
How much have we talked about it? It's been one of our big talking points in the commentary. The lack of set-piece goals from the Seagulls this season. This would be a good time to get one. Gross is going to take the corner from the right. Into the box it goes. Van Hecker's up there. Downward header, chested forward there by Mitoma. It's scooped over the line and into the back of the net. The City defenders claim handball. Mitoma thinks he may have scored. It will be checked.
No, it's free kick. He's given a free kick.
He has given a free kick.
It's a great flick on from Danny Welbeck.
It was. It came down and it looks like it's been ruled out.
Check, we're checking.
Albion with the ball in the net. Well, a good downward header by Welbeck. He sort of seemed to go with his chest, I think,
handballed.
Initially.
I think Mitoma knows he's handballed it.
It wasn't too convincing with the celebration. That's the first one's with the chest.
There you are.
I think it's his body.
Yeah, but it's handball, Johnny. It's not initially handball, but it is handball.
Well, it's been ruled out. It won't count.
I think it's not the first instance, Johnny. It's when it's landed on the ball.
Harsh, maybe?
It's harsh, but it's the right decision, isn't it?
There's a bit of chest, a bit of arm, a bit of everything. It's just the body, the momentum of his body taking him forward. So it's not, I don't think you can blame him. And actually, Ortega it was who cleared it against Mitoma. Sometimes those little bit of luck of what you need against a top quality side.
But I think you have to finish it straight away, don't you? Mm. It's a great flick from him. We're touching the straws, aren't we? He should be finishing that.
Yes, he should. Oh, poor ball
by Gilmore.
He should
be going with his chest. He should be going with his foot.
Yes, yeah, absolutely right. It was a strange one, wasn't it? Because it low down on the half volley.
He didn't knee it in.
Yeah, it was sweeping in.
Yeah. Chest, not
any part of the leg, but it remains 1-0 to Manchester City. It's given the Amex crowd some belief that they can get themselves back level. And Welbeck has caused City a few problems this evening.
Yeah, he has, yes.
Here's Bernardo Silva, left side of midfield, inside the City half. Rico Lewis rolling it back there to Rodri. And across to Ortega. City just trying to take the sting out of things now, I think, because that intensity was helping Albion for a bit. Only a few 50-50 challenges. Haaland coming off the front line to Lewis on the left. Back infield to De Bruyne. Seems to have so much time on the ball. A wonderful brain. Now Lewis, great young talent, using Foden. English international back to De Bruyne. Brendan Otte, let him go there. You've got to get back if you can, even if you have lost it and got.
What Haaland is for the City side is a focal point, isn't it? Mm. They hit him, he laid it off, and his first instinct is, I'm going back into the middle. Mm. I'm going to stay out wider. Well, I'm the focal point of this side going forward.
And then as a defender, you don't know whether to go with him or go towards the ball. He sucks you in, and then he can peel away too. Hoisted to the left, Foden the goal scorer, left side of the box, up against Pascal Gross, rolls it in there to Bernardo Silva, back to Foden again, couple on the edge of the box, one is De Bruyne, dinks it forward, Foden on the volley, hoists it high towards the back post, Mahrez brings it under control, first touch is a good one, back there on the right to Kyle Walker, Albion keeping their shape well there, and forcing City back to halfway. Worked that by the Albion defence. Now Rodri will have to just push a little bit further into the Albion half. Bernardo Silva on the left. Up the line to Foden. Back to Bernardo Silva again. Scampers across. Nice reverse ball with his right foot to Van Rico Lewis, who dips his shoulder and goes into the middle. In there to Haaland. Caicedo did well there. Rico Lewis fouls him. Free kick.
Good play there from us, because he didn't dive in, just tracked the runner. Had a 1-2 with Haaland and he just got his body between the ball. Just watching the free kick again, Johnny. Spinning away from the goalkeeper. He gives no chance, has he?
No.
With the free kick.
No, I think Kevin De Bruyne would have been happy with that free kick. And here is Danny Welbeck, who took it. Uses Caicedo. Away from Haaland to the left. Colwell along the ground to Mitoma, allowed to turn. Walker was backing up. Estupiñán on the outside. He looks up. Takes a touch, now he crosses, whips it across the face of goal. Oh, and it's headed down there by Guenonotte, and it comes off Rico Lewis, and then back onto Guenonotte, I think, and out for a goal kick. Dangerous ball, that, from Purvis Estupiñán, right across the face of goal. It went all the way through to Guenonotte. Lewis just about got himself in the position to block it.
I think if Entice runs a near post and he gets an header, doesn't he? He's gone all the way across the face of the goal. It's good play, because what they did, they ganged up on Walker, made it two against one. Morris couldn't get back, so Estupian and Matoma ganged up on him and got the just rewards. And put
here's
a great
Gwen Onate running to the edge of the box. Left footed, parried away there by Ortega. Lovely little weaving run there by Facundo Gwen Onate. Albion pushing for an equaliser. Now to Matoma, left side. Onto his right foot, squares it. Gwen Onate again, overran it slightly. Estupinian, wide to Caicedo, dinks it into the box. Beyond Welbeck, headed away there by Foden. Immediately, De Bruyne's onto it. Billy Gilmore brought him down. I think he slightly ran across him there, and Simon Hooper saying that's why it shouldn't be a yellow card, but it will be a free kick.
Yeah, and just going back there, Johnny, going off, it's a lovely bit of skill, isn't it, from him. Jinkin, we talk about Foden doing it for Man City, but then Otto's doing it for Brighton. Getting on the ball, driving at the City defence, getting a shot to that. But I think he telegraphed it a little bit, didn't he?
Yeah, and it was quite a nice height for him. Got it onto his favoured left foot. It's just a couple of foot off the ground. It's a nice one to parry away, as they used to say, a nice one for the cameras. But what a 36 minutes of football we've had here at the Amex. City still leading by that Foden goal. Kyle Walker just pinching a couple of yards with the free kick there. Oh, and look at the chances that Albion have had, Warren.
Yeah,
I think the Zambia will be frustrated that they haven't scored. Probably the free kick, chance for Matoma, the chance for Gwen Onate. Had opportunities. Forward comes Van Hecke, missed that challenge. Billy Gilmore, though, with the cycle kick back to his keeper. Steal. Taking his time on the edge of the box. Van Hecke going into the right back position. Steele just trying to calm things down a little. Fitness of these guys, Warren, unbelievable, isn't it? You know, get to this stage of the season, I know they don't need to train much, but nicely off there by Welbeck to find Enciso, just inside the City half, across to the right wing, finds Gwen Onate. Gwen Onate now, looking for options. Gross on the outside. Back to the Argentinian once more, using Gilmore, sweeps it back to Van Hecke. And Hecke. A little short pass to Gross, who sweeps it back there to Steele.
And Zerbi wanted Pascal Gross to go forward.
Yeah.
In there at half, and now back in there on 18 yard box.
Good ball by Steele to pick out Colwell. Up to halfway, into the City half, still going. Short pass forward to Enciso. He looks up, shoots. Oh! He's done it again! First at Stamford Bridge, now at the Amex. It's an absolute perler from Julio Enciso. Albion 1, Manchester City 1.
Oh, Zerbi was complaining. That pass to goes back to his goalkeeper. But Jason Steele once again set the attack off. It went to Colwell, he drove forward, fed it into Enciso. And saying, go on, go forward. And I thought the one at Chelsea was the goal of the season. That might just benefit it now. Absolutely wonderful strike. What more can you ask for?
Well, we were just saying how they might rue some of their missed chances. There was no missing that from Julio Enciso. He took a touch, got it out of his feet, picked his spot. Ortega was floundering.
Johnny, I'm not asking questions like that. Could be a goal of the season. Started with a goalkeeper, into Colwell, took it forward, and Cisse, and top corner.
Well, a few more cheers as the replays go on the big screens. Massive celebrations from the backroom staff. Remember, a point guarantees Europa League football. Oh, it's given away straight out of play. Maldera's not happy. Well, Zerbi wasn't happy with Julio Enciso's performance after the goal at Stamford Bridge. He needs to keep going. Here's Welbeck. Here's the handball. Vantage played there by Simon Hooper.
No advantage from the handball, is there?
No. will be a free kick.
Pep's not happy with his City side. They're 6 and 7s at the moment.
Well, it's a big handball by Walker. Free kick taken by Caicedo to Gross across to the right hand side. 5 minutes remaining in the first half here on BBC Radio Sussex Sport. Van Hecker goes to Colwell. It's Colwell's run who started it. Lovely little turn there by Enciso. Now he's away from his man. Brought down again. Bernardo Silva, yellow card.
That's what I like about Enciso. And he gets the ball on the half turn and he drives at the defenders. And that's what we were saying, Dunny. He has to take fouls now. Before he used to roll and roll and roll. But there, he's got beyond him. He's taken a whack. He's got up. Mm. And that's what he has to do.
Yeah.
He's going to take more than that. You look at Grealish. Just take a leaf out of Grealish's book. He gets whacked. Most Premier League player, but he gets up and gets it. Just give him the ball again. Keep giving him the ball.
Well, he's got the equaliser. Now he's got the free kick. Gross and Estupiñán standing over it. Touched off by Estupiñán to Gross. Gross drags it back to the left. Estupiñán once more is inside the box here. Kills it back post. Oh, it's just out of play for a corner.
Deflection. He's asking for a ball, isn't he? Estupiñán. Look at Mahrez. He's got his hands down his side. But again, well worked free kick.
Yeah, well disguised. Little touch off and the reverse ball. Swung in again. Another corner, this time down the left hand side. Deserbi takes a glug of water, then throws his bottle down on the ground. Hands in pockets, looking to the far corner, where Pascal Gross will take this from the left-hand side. It did hit an arm, but it was, as you say, down the side of the body. Gross just telling Mahrez to move back a bit, and it is played short to Mitoma. Mitoma, Gilmore to Gross. Gross swings it in. Big leap, headed away there by Rodri. Just got in front of Colwell. Good clear by Bernardo Silva. Moises Caicedo going back towards his own goal. Just turns it on to halfway and Pascal Gross. 3 minutes left of normal time in this first half. Albion 1, Manchester City 1, live on BBC Radio Sussex.
What a game of football, though, we're witnessing tonight.
Well, you said it was going to be a cracker. And you weren't wrong. Nice layoff by Welbeck. Caicedo forward to Enciso. He goes wide, finds Buonanotte. Buonanotte now jinking away from his man, going square across the pitch. Dinks it forward. Good run from Estupiñán, trying to head it across to Mitoma, who hadn't really made the run and anticipated it coming his way. Cleared by Ortega. Picked up by Billy Gilmore over on the left hand side. Wide to the touchline. Mitoma jinking away from his marker to Buonanotte. Can they find just one more chance in the latter stages of this first half?
What Pep's witnessing here, Dunny, is his team being taken apart in the last 20 minutes by Brighton. Isn't it? The football we're playing.
Yeah, it's been excellent wonderful. So far. Here's Gross, up to Buonanotte. He's had a good 45 minutes. Now Gilmore, oh, it's a poor ball. I'm quite sure whether he was trying to find Mitoma or Estupiñán. It didn't work. Here's the keeper, Ortega, on his six-yard box, stabbing it forward. Up there goes Van Hecker. Good header down there to Caicedo. Van Hecker again, drifting forward in the central position on the pitch. Wide to the left, finds Mitoma. Mitoma rolls it forward, good run by Welbeck. Left footed, 2-1 Albion. There's a flag, it won't count. It's a brilliant finish, but it remains 1-1.
It is a good finish, isn't it? But look at Pep now, he's on the floor on his knees, Johnny. Waving his arms from the sky and just saying, calm down, just offside, bro. Knee offside, Johnny, unbelievable, small margins, eh? Pep will be glad to get in at 1-1, that's where they will be, 1 minute to go in this half, get him in at one, and there'll be sparks flying in that dressing room.
I think you could hear what the Amex crowd think of it. 3 minutes, I think, will be added on at the, or maybe two, we'll see. Forward it goes by Ortega. Glancing header by Haaland, picked up by Mahrez. Mahrez driving down the right side of the Albion box, trying to get to the goal line. Pulls it back, De Bruyne, he curls it in, back post. Foden, cross the goal, oh, it just kissed the top of the crossbar. Goal kick, still 1-1. What a game.
Yeah, what a game. Chances at both ends. Oh, but yeah, it's a lovely ball from De Bruyne. I think he's aiming for Haaland, really. It's just over the bar. Free header, back post. Both gone to Haaland. Colwell and Pascal Gross. Free header, 6 yards out. Has to hit the target.
So 3 minutes to be added on at the end of the first half.
I just want to keep it going, Johnny. Forget the break. Just turn around straight away. Let's go again.
As you say, it's coming at a better time for City than it is for the Albion.
Oh, that's for sure. But then again, it's so dangerous, aren't they?
That's it. You think you got them on the rack, and then suddenly, it's a good chance there for Foden. Could have had his second of the game. Oh, what's the skipping Jan done there? He's blasted it back towards his own goal. He was trying to go with the outside of his boot. Gross goes to the corner of the pitch. Another little drag back to get away from Foden. Trying to send it up towards Mitoma. Forward comes Walker. Into Gundogan. Rodri. Through there. Good challenge by Van Hecker. And Colwell turns it back to Steele. Steele hitting it first time to the touchline. Renan Otte up against Rico Lewis. Hurt himself there. I'm not sure. Sure, it was much of a contact since he just launched himself and slightly missed time. It will be a free kick.
I think he's hurt himself there, man, jumping up in the air.
I don't think Rico Lewis did a great deal, to be honest.
It's like me when in the swimming bath, so just trying to do a bomb. That was, isn't it? Boom! No water left.
Well, you'll get to that swimming pool soon, Warren. Well,
that's history, finish. Just watching a replay.
I mean, it starts outside the goal, it swings in. I mean, there's no keeper's going to save it.
Not even if put Edison on his shoulders, wouldn't say that, Johnny, would it?
No. Free kick then for the Albion, inside their own half. Gross, back from Gilmore. Gilmore, back to the keeper. Bernardo Silva decides to press. Steele having to hurry to get that clear, and Rodri's downward header is picked up by Gross, who just launches it across the pitch, but it's found Mitoma. Mitoma up against Walker on halfway. Skips inside. Welbeck's made a run in the middle, but he's gone down the line to Enciso. Good decision that. They've got three in the middle here. Enciso onto his right foot, curls it in. Welbeck unmarked. Oh, and it's missed completely. And Rico Lewis clears.
Manager's on his knees, Zerbi. Can't believe it, he's missed it there. What you see from Daniel Welbeck, this first half, Johnny, we've seen sublime.
To the ridiculous.
Correct. We have. Simple as.
Oh, dear. Poor old Daddy Welbeck. He probably deserves a few more goals.
Like head on a stick, that, wasn't it? Oh, his head come off. He swung it at it that hard.
Oh, it seemed to take an eternity to get to him. Foul by Brendan Otte there on Rodri.
50-50 that one for me. 6'2" against 5'8".
Oh, it was a lovely build-up, wasn't it? Oh. The ball from Mitoma to Enciso. He was totally unmarked as well. Half-time. Scintillating 45 minutes from both sides. Chances from start to finish, but just two goals. Foden gave City the lead. And Albion equalising with another wonderful strike by Julio Enciso. They had the ball in the net twice. Mitoma judged to have handballed. Meanwhile, Welbeck, he was offside when he shot into the top right-hand corner. City did have other chances. Haaland and Foden should have done better with headers. But we go into the break. All square at 1-1.
Yeah, I didn't want that first half to finish. Man, some of the football was unbelievable. Chances at both ends. Well, the keepers, both keepers not made a save, have they, really? It's been missed chances.
Steele came out and blocked one, didn't he?
But the chances both sides have had have been very good. But some of the football and some of the movement. Pascal Gross has done that cross turn three times. And the City players have fell for it three times. It's just wonderful football. And Cissé, what a finish that is. That's goal of the season for me.
Looks like he may have injured himself, actually. They're getting a bit of a chat there from the backroom staff as well. But Albion have risen to the occasion. I mean, they could have been ahead, City, couldn't they? A header for Haaland, you know, after just 6 minutes, 4 yards out, should have buried it. But then they had their chances. Gilmore, Welbeck. I mean, I've got probably 6-7 really good chances, Warren.
Yes. That Welbeck, though, that last-minute header there. He threw his head at it, and I thought his head was going to come off. He came back that far, and he never connected with it. Oh, you have to a connection to put pressure on the goalkeeper. It's just it's wonderful football. It's And just like I say, don't want them to come out now. Let's get back out. I don't want to go for a cup of tea at half time. Get out, let's start again. The football's been sent to lace.
It has. And probably two of the teams with the most attractive football in the Premier League this season.
It is, and then that's why they both manage to respect each other, don't they? And any fan now watching this on TV, I mean, look at this football from both sides. It's just wonderful. And the chances they're both creating. It's good football to watch, isn't it? Wish I could have played football like this.
Well, Pep Guardiola said, didn't he, that they're creating an average of over 20 chances per game. And actually, we know, don't we, for a fact, since De Zerbi joined the Albion, there's been more goals in their games than any other team. 104 goals in Albion matches since he took charge. That's entertainment.
That's entertainment. Who sang that?
There's the Jam, I think.
Oh, Arms just popped up there. I thought he was nodding off, but yeah, Armsy knows his music. But yes, what a game, Armsy.
Well, can I just say one thing, fellas, actually? Buonanotte for me tonight has been outstanding. Is that I mean, I don't see as much of these guys as you.
I'd probably say it's been his best performance so far.
Been magnificent,
sure.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, but they've been competitive as well. I think they've battled hard, haven't they, Warren, in terms of, you know, you said they were a little bit rattled at time, and I think they thought that maybe Albion might be a soft touch, play lovely football and everything, but I think they've been strong in the tackle as well.
Yeah, they've been strong on Haaland. He's not let him have the three headers and that.
Van Hecker, I think, deserves a bit of praise.
Yeah,
I agree.
But
no.
Going on, Buonanotte, it's the first time I've seen him run at defenders. Sometimes he just gets it and lays it back and that's it. Well, I can still do that. Given the ball, I'll just whip, knock it back. But no, today I've seen him take it on. Bit like Foden does on this side, cuts inside, and he's got a little turn of pace, what gets you into the little gaps in between defenders. Great, it's great watching both teams.
It's been wonderful. Fellas, go get a cup of tea because you deserve it. What a first half. I think that's the best half of football that I've seen this season. That was absolutely sensational. I think we probably all need to have a little breather. We have a little break and then we're going to hear from Mark McGee, former Albion manager who played in Europe. Of course, he won the European Cup Winners' Cup. We'll hear about that in a few moments' time here on BBC Radio Sussex. Well, the time is coming up to 8 minutes to 9 o'clock.
BBC Radio Sussex.
You've lost yourself in an amazing interview that's just getting to the juiciest bit. When... Download the BBC Sounds app and you'll never miss another moment. With the tap of a button, you can go back to the start of any live show. Pause the radio at any time and even rewind to listen again and again. Play, pause and rewind. Local BBC radio that you control. Listen on BBC Sounds.
BBC Radio Sussex.
Welcome back to the Amex. Well, what a first half that was. It really was extraordinary football. City with a very strong side out tonight, but the Albion more than matching them and, you know, possibly with a better chance as well. You know, don't go anywhere because it's a sensational game of football and as ever beautifully described by Johnny and Warren. Well, let's hear from the former Albion manager, Mark McGee, who spoke to us on Albion Unlimited podcast earlier on this week. Mark, who played in the European Cup Winners' Cup final for Aberdeen back in 1983. He had a taste of European football then as they won the European Cup Winners' Cup managed by Sir Alex Ferguson. And as I say, he joined us on the Albion Unlimited podcast earlier this week.
Yeah, marvellous really. And, you know, you can track the progress over these last, whatever it is, 5 years. And, you know, obviously we're going all the way back to the new stadium and all of that. But, you know, the progress has been incremental, but it's been forward all the time. And now, to achieve European football is just, you know, it's fantastic. You know, myself and my youngest son are season ticket holders. And, you know, the first thing he said when he came out of the game on Sunday, was it? You know, can we go to the first European game away? And his mum said, well, where is it? And he says, I don't know, but just book a flight to everywhere. And we'll be sure getting on, you know, so... You know, they're absolutely loving it, him and his friends, and they're it's just fantastic.
I mean, in all likelihood, it's going to be the Europa League, obviously barring the most incredible turnaround in goal difference. So that means big clubs as well. You talk about venues you could be going to. It could be Inter, Milan, Leverkusen. I mean, this is big time, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, given that the prospect of European football for the club was looming, Archie, my son, and I did a lot of a recce on how many times I had played in Europe. And I think I got up to something like 57 games I played in Europe. you know, between Aberdeen, Hamburg and Celtic. And those were my favourite games of all the games I ever played. You know, the European football was fantastic, you know, travelling to these places. You know, and we were lucky. I played against, and you mentioned Inter, played against Inter, played against Bayern Munich, played against Hamburg, played against Real Madrid, you know, but equally we played against Sion, and we played against teams from the Faroe Islands and smaller, and from, you know, at that time, communist countries, Albania, Bulgaria, Czechoslovakia as it was then, Hungary, Poland, you know, it's a fantastic experience for the players, but also for the supporters.
So there we are. That was Mark McGee talking to us on the Albion Limited podcast. The applause all around the ground here at the Amex is because Toma Hemed, who played for the Albion in that wonderful promotion season and played in the Premier League as well, he's just got a fantastic standing ovation around here at the Amex. He's now being interviewed pitchside, and it's just great to see him. He's very smartly dressed in a suit. He's got a collar and tie on, and he's just being interviewed pitchside and just saying how much he enjoyed himself here at the Amex. He still looks very fit as well as Toma Hemed. Wonderful to see him here. He's getting a terrific round of applause. 97 appearances for the Albion, and he scored some really important goals, particularly in that promotion winning season, and also in the Albion that first season in the Premier League under Chris Hughton. Always a pleasure to interview, and he's pitch side now, and he got a great ovation from the Albion fan. Well, let's hear from the Albion chief executive Paul Barber after securing European football this season. He spoke this morning to BBC Radio's Five Lives, Rick Edwards.
I'm really pleased with the way the season has gone. It's been a bit of a roller coaster at times. We've had a lot of ups, but one or two downs along the way. But it's been a great experience, and we're obviously looking forward to next season already.
When you lost Graham Potter in September last year, one of the most highly rated young managers around, did you have confidence that you might be able to have this level of success?
Well, I think in the Premier League, it's very difficult if you're a club of our size to have that level of confidence. But I think, you know, we knew Roberto De Zerbi was a very talented coach. We knew that if we could secure his services, then we had a good chance of maintaining the momentum that Graham had created over three seasons. And obviously, as the season has gone on, the confidence of the players has grown. Roberto's knowledge of the Premier League has grown. And we're in the position we're in. So there are no guarantees at this level of football, but we've certainly worked very hard to be where we are.
Was it important to make sure that you brought someone in whose kind of footballing philosophy was at least similar to that you had under Graham Potter, so there wasn't too much of a step change?
Absolutely. I think, you know, one of the challenges of any club making a managerial change, in our case it was enforced, is manager coming in and wanting a completely different squad to the one you've got. And we didn't have that luxury. You know, this happened a month into the season. Graham left us in September. So when Roberto came in, he was very much going to be working with the squad that we had right the way until at least January transfer window. So we certainly didn't have that luxury, but we also knew the style of football that he played would fit the squad that we had. And that was a very key part of our recruitment process and our succession planning.
And what's it been like working with him?
It's been lively at times.
But, I like the sound of that.
You know, he's an incredibly hardworking man. He's a very decent man. He's a great communicator. He's a great motivator of the players. He's very careful on the attention to detail on the training field every day, working long hours. The players absolutely love him. And obviously the type of football that we've been playing, I think, has converted a few of the neutrals to be Brighton fans. So we've certainly enjoyed it, and you know, we hope we'll be working with him for some time to come. He's been brave all season. You know, we've scored a lot of goals, played a lot of young players. We've played a particular type of football that requires the players to be brave and have trust in the coach and trust in each other.
Getting into sixth place, which means you've secured European football next season. You must be incredibly excited about that, and also aware that you're going to have to do quite a lot of work in the summer to get ready for it.
We're really excited. Obviously, we're pleased for the fans who've been through quite a lot over the last 25 years. Delighted for the chairman who's invested so much in the club. But yes, it's another level of football. It's another level of preparation. There's going to be more demands on our players, more demands on our staff, and a lot of excitement, I think, for our fans. So, you know, although we are looking forward to sort of the hard work, we're also looking forward to a different adventure for the club. You know, the first time in 122 years that we'll be playing at this level of football. So it's something we can really look forward to.
I think it's a testament to how impressive Brighton have been this season that there must have been part of you that thought Champions League might be possible.
You're certainly always aiming as high as you possibly can as part of our club's culture, part of our values to do that. But I think when you look at the clubs around you, Manchester City, Arsenal, Newcastle, Liverpool, Manchester United, you know, you have to be realistic as well. And you know, we knew, you know, going through the season that we always had a chance. We've beaten sort of most of those clubs along the way. So we knew that we were playing well enough to be at that level. But I think you've got to be realistic. The top four is, you know, a very, very difficult thing to achieve in the Premier League for even the biggest clubs. So, you know, we're certainly going to continue to aim higher. We hope that we can tie down 100% the Europa League place in the next two games, and then see where next season takes us.
Getting into Europe will presumably help to attract new players. One thing that you know you are going to have to cope with is other clubs coming in for some of your stars, though.
I think it's one of the prices of the success that we've had, and that we understand that, you know, the better we play, the more interest there is in us, the more interest there is in our people. But we have to plan for that. We have to be ready for that. We have to be, you know, respectful of the fact that the players will want to play at the highest level they can. Playing at the highest level we can gives us the best chance of keeping those players for longer. But, you know, we're prepared and we're ready should the worst happen and we lose one of those two players, one or two of those players along the way. That's part and parcel of football for pretty much any club in the world. Even the biggest clubs lose their best players from time to time. We have to be ready for that, and we will be.
So there we are. That's Paul Barber. What a wonderful few days it's been for the Albion. A couple of tweets. In fact, just as we speak to you, Toma Hemed was on the pitch a few moments ago. He's just come up to the press area, just taking a photograph of him with Johnny. What a lovely man Toma Hemed is, Johnny.
Oh, my God, I can't believe it. I mean, he came up to give me a massive hug, and do you know what? At that era, he was brilliant. You remember those penalties? He was so cool, so calm. And he was a really good footballer, intelligent footballer. God, he looks fitter now than he did.
He looks really
fit. Oh, my God.
I
tell you what, lads, we all need to move to Israel, I think, because he looks... Tommy Hemed. Hemed, I mean, he was good with his head.
Yes.
Lovely, like, touch as well. Brilliant from the penalty spot. And how lovely for him to be here today.
I think he's lost about 3 scores, hasn't he?
That's why we need to get out there, Warren. Well, I did say to him, there is a possibility that Albion might pay Maccabi Haifa, which is in the north of Israel. And he'll be there. And he still keeps in contact with Baram Kayal, who's also playing in Israel as well.
Wonderful. It's really good to see him, and he's got a great ovation here. A few messages have come in. Raven in Worthing says, just one word, fabulous about that first half. And Anthony in Eastbourne says, top class from Brighton. It really was. What a wonderful first half here at the Annex. If the second half is anything like the first half, it'd be an absolute classic here at the Amex. The Albion players are out on the pitch. We're just waiting for Manchester City to re-emerge. Hopefully Johnny and Warren have got their breath back. Let's rejoin our commentary team here at the Amex Stadium. It's the former Albion striker Warren Aspinall, and your match commentator is Johnny Cantor.
Thanks very much indeed, Adrian. Yeah, lovely to see Tom Ahmed. There's a little bit of a concern over Julio Enciso, but he has come out for the second half, so good news, because I think the replays have just been shown again and again and again of that wonderful strike. Evan Ferguson's just getting a few instructions there, so I'm not quite sure what's going on there. But a few whistles because City are taking so long, but now they are coming out and they're getting booed as they come out. And I would have thought that's because Pep Guardiola's got a lot of information that he wants to relay to his team, because certainly half-time, Warren, came at a better time for City than it did for the Seagulls.
Yeah, certainly did. But then they had a little chance, didn't they, just before the...
Yes.
The Foden's header. It's end-to-end, isn't it? It's a wonderful game of football.
What have Albion got to do to maintain that performance in the second half, Warren?
Take one of these chances. That's what they have to do. Give them a chance. Because I can't see City not having some more chances. I think they will have chances in this game. I'm sure they will. But it's about who puts them away.
Well, it's one apiece. And it's live on BBC Radio Sussex here from the Amex. The Seagulls attacking the North Stand. So from this, the West Stand, as we look on, they're playing from right to left in their blue and white stripes, white shorts and white socks.
equaliser for Julio Enciso after Phil Foden had put them on their way. And here's Jason Steele on the edge of his box, up there towards Mitoma. Good header by Walker, just goes over Levi Colwell, who you mentioned earlier, was name checked by Gareth Southgate today. It's in the England under 21 squad. Well, maybe some people think he could have even been close to being in the full squad as well, but I say they're pushing that away. City in possession, Rodri to the left side, Silva operating on the left, and there with Phil Foden, and they've been quite effective in that first half. Now Rodri again. Just trying to get back into the swing of things. People taking their seats a little bit late, maybe enjoying that first half performance. What a game of football it's been so far. I'm sure there's plenty more goal mouth action to come, with Albion looking to secure a place in the Europa League. City trying to continue this winning run. It's Gundogan, just inside his own half, to halfway. Rico Lewis lays it off. De Bruyne out on the left there, perched, goes through the legs of one, but wasn't kept past Billy Gilmore. And Ciso tries to challenge there with Welbeck, but Rodri, big, tall, imposing structure of a man.
It's a good shake from Brighton, isn't it?
Yes, good header away there by Pascal Gross. It needed to be, because De Bruyne had made a forward run into the left channel. Bernardo Silva has it now, over on that left-hand side. Gundogan getting involved too. We mentioned those six changes for City. A lot of their big-name stars in the starting 11. De Bruyne is one of those. He's in possession. Wide to Bernardo Silva. Haaland in the middle. Curled towards him now. Left-footed sideways volley. Loops up and over the bar. Big smile there from Erling Haaland.
He goes there, Johnny, with his foot. Really, he's... I don't know, with his head.
Yeah, he's tried that a couple of times in this game, hasn't he?
Must hurt him when he falls.
Well, he hasn't had a bad season, has he?
No, no, but like you say, Johnny, he's probably missed some chances as well. He missed a couple today.
Yeah, he certainly has. Could have added to his impressive total. Steele now, waiting for Silva to come towards him. Chips it up there towards Welbeck, but it's headed down by City. Gundogan taking it to the left. And he's scanning with his eyes, now rolling it into Bernardo Silva. It's just behind him, given away by Caicedo, and Silva has another chance to lay out Foden. He sends it back post, spinning away from Haaland. And then Estupiñán passes it forward up towards Mitoma. Kyle Walker very strong there against Mitoma to win it. Now Mahrez getting to the edge of the box, to the left, gets it back from De Bruyne. And he needs to try to clear their lines, and here's Haaland, edge of the box, lays it off. Gundogan shoots just across the face of goal and goes behind for a corner.
It's a good deflection, hasn't it? Off Corwell, but they were trying to run it out, aren't we? First of all, they lost it, then we try to run it out. Haaland plays, Gundogan just gone wide. It's a little nick from Corwell.
Yeah, important nick as well. Steele trying to guard both his front and rear post. I think they're going to make a change. City.
I think McAllister's coming on as well for Brighton.
Yeah, he's warming up to our left.
And Ferguson.
Yeah, Ferguson was certainly preparing himself earlier. They've taken the corner short, City. Here, Mahrez to the edge of the box. Foden onto his right foot. Tees it up for Rico Lewis. He shoots, but it's straight at Steele. Well, it's going to be Cole Palmer to come on for City. Made in the 1-0 victory against Chelsea. I watched the highlights, thought he looked very impressive. You like him a lot, don't you, Warren?
Yeah, I do. He's a bit like Foden, isn't he? Left-footed player, drives it. He's only a slight build of a footballer, but lovely touch, lovely balance.
But when you get these young players, Warren, there's Van Hecker taking it from defence there up to Mitoma. Shot off the first challenge, but then there's a slip by Estupiñán. Out for a city. Throw the changes are coming. Ferguson will be one
Foden.
Of them.
I think he was carrying a little knock. Must have been, yeah, he's limping off.
And a double change coming up for Albion. wait for the numbers to come up to see who's coming off. But when you get a player coming on who's a youngster, he wants to impress, so actually it's not a bad thing. I know people say, well, you want to put your... In this city, you've got to do well to get in the city squad, let alone get in the team.
Yeah. Well, yeah, you have to be ready when you're called upon, don't you? You
certainly do.
See, sir.
Yep.
Very surprised, but he surprised the player. Didn't know he was coming off.
And
Billy Gilmore
is coming off.
Gilmore is replaced by number 28, Evan Ferguson. Also coming off, number 27, Billy Gilmore.
So we don't often see it, but Welbeck and Ferguson both on the pitch at the same time. Doesn't look too happy there, Billy Gilmore, to be coming off at this juncture.
And neither did
And Billy is replaced by number 10, Alexis McAllister.
And Cecil wasn't happy neither.
Yeah, of course, Nciso did get a whack, but he was okay to start this game in that win over Southampton.
Well, there's no way,
Yeah, so yeah, punching at his chest as if to say, who, me?
Yeah.
Yes, you. So, three changes made in total. One for City, two for Albion.
You used to have a little chat at half-time, saying, look, about 5 minutes into the second half.
Well, Ferguson was definitely going to come on quite quickly because he was receiving instructions from Andrea Maldera just before we restarted. So he's playing two up top at the moment. He may be playing off the left here, Ferguson, but a clearance by Ortega. Headed down there by Estupiñán to Colwell. Onto Facundo Buonanotte, back by his international compatriot, Alexis McAllister. He releases it to the left. Estupiñán, midway through the City half. Back inside his own half now to Levi Colwell. Reminder, Lewis Dunk not involved so far. City ping it up there to Haaland. Good tackle there by Van Hecker. Gundogan though, curling it across to Palmer. His first contribution to get to the edge of the box. Onto his left foot and he shoots. And it's a good save by Steele. Put it away from the danger area. And then Estupiñán gets it up the pitch and wins the throw.
So he wasn't looking for the cross there, was he? Palmer gets it out of his feet. Backing off past the gloves. Thought, okay, I'll have a shot. It's a good save.
It's a good
palm
save.
Away. Strong hands.
Good distance as well to get it away and out towards the edge of his box from Jason Steele. Van Hecker. He's got some good challenges in this game. And he's found Ferguson. Comes halfway. Back to McAllister. Sends Estupiñán forward, but it's just on the angle and it'll go one bounce and out of play.
See the right idea from McAllister. Good run, Estupiñán saw the space in behind Carl Walker.
Just looking at the shape though, Warren, does it now mean that Albion have got just the two in the central part of midfield? Sure. Ferguson pushing on the left, Welbeck on the right. So important roles for Caicedo and McAllister. Here's John Stones, short to the edge of his own box, away by Bernardo Silva to Rodri. Rodri taking it away from Buonanotte, using Rico Lewis. Still 20 yards inside his own half. Back to Rodri once more. Alvarez is going to come on shortly.
I think that might be Haaland coming on.
Well, I wouldn't be surprised if both sides use all five substitutions today. Here's Bernardo Silva off down the left channel. Cole Palmer outside. Palmer now back to Silva, who goes down, getting a penalty. Big smile between the two, but Silva says this is a foul, but
I think there's a little tug.
There was a little tug, wasn't there? Well, the ball hasn't gone out of play. I wonder whether the tug might have just been outside the box, but Steele still has it at his feet, so we will wait. It's beyond Welbeck, and off the flank comes Mitoma. Mitoma sending it over the top. Buonanotte gives chase, but Ortega's out of his area and calmly plays it forward, but he's misplaced it. It goes to Gross rather than Palmer, and Gross using Buonanotte again on the right. Little ball into Ferguson. Oh, tried to lay it off to Gross. I think he wasn't sure whether to lay it off or not, but Gross has won it back. Ferguson hits it! Oh, and Ortega saves it as near post. Out for a corner.
That's a guy who's full of confidence in himself. there, Ferguson. Little instinct there, just came back to him. First thought, hit the target, and that's what he does, makes the goalkeeper make a save.
What I love about it, that even though the touch had gone, he's still back up on his feet, and his first thought is to get it on target. Forced the save, they have the corner. Gross going across to the right-hand side. And Hecker on the six-yard box. Ferguson's in there too. Flicked in there. Good glancing header by Ferguson. Forced the edge of the box. Hit low into the ground by Caicedo. And City's defence holds firm. Comes back to Caicedo, who releases Mitoma. Mitoma on the left. Three around him at the moment. Estupiñán back into the middle. McAllister switching it from left to right. Using Gross. He's got height to pick out now. Pascal Gross. Curling it towards Welbeck. He leaves it, hit on the volley by Mitoma over the bar, well over the bar, goal kick, still 1-1.
Again, just half a chance that, isn't it, for me? Half a chance. Great bit of skill for Pascal Gross. Delayed, and picks him out, back post. Wasteful chance.
So it's De Bruyne who's going to come off. Alvarez will come on. I do like this guy. Now we have Alvarez and Haaland on the pitch.
World Cup winner. Johnny scored a penalty, didn't he? One of the penalties.
And the way that they're lined up with four across the front, it's a bit like a De Zerbi formation.
I think De Zerbi's learned enough pep, hasn't he?
Here's Ortega to Rodri, still inside his own box, on the left side, to the touchline. Palmer doesn't get the header. Missed. Gross into the feet of Caicedo. Now McAllister. He's stroking the ball around since coming on. Now to the back, Van Hecker, Colwell crosses body into the channel, layoff by Mitoma trying to find Ferguson. His touch led him down though. The Republic of Ireland international has to give chase and go and find John Stones, who's made his way up the pitch. Rolls it across to Palmer on the left. Haaland in the middle. Palmer, I mean, you go there at Pascal Gross. Gross just puts a foot out, holds him up, checks the run. Palmer still has it though. He might need a little bit of help, but he's maintain possession very well indeed, but then his pass lets himself down.
Well, you're going to pass the goals there. Great defending. Held him up.
Yeah, he did really, really well. Here's Buenanotte up the right touchline. Needs to shield that away from the City players. Now Gross into the middle. Ferguson trying to take it beyond him, but Gundogan gets it into Haaland. He plays it on, and Colwell's right-footed clearance isn't a great one. He's helped out there by Pascal Gross, who sends it high towards the right touchline. Darkness descending here at the Amex. Warm evening. Gross into Ferguson again. His first touch lets him down. He's trying to, rather than just get it under control, he's trying to take it away from his man as well. Estupiñán fouls his man, which is Alvarez, and it'll be a free kick to City midway through the Albion half.
Ferguson. Couple of occasions now, it's come up to him, hasn't it? That half a chance what he had there, that was a poor first touch, and twice now in the centre circle, you try to play him, just get all of it. Take a hit, get us a foul.
Yeah, he's trying to sort of take it and go at the same time, isn't he? Maybe just trying to do a little bit too much, but. As it goes to the left hand side to Bernardo Silva. Coming up to 15 minutes played in the second half. Still one apiece if you're just joining us on BBC Radio Sussex. Penultimate game of the season for the Seagulls. Here's Gundogan. Looking across the pitch. Curls it right-footed to Walker. Walker looks up. Hits it. And it's well wide, as you can probably hear from the cheers and the jeers from the Albion fans.
Yeah. Poor decision-making from Kyle Walker there. Marlowe's wanted it wide, didn't he, to get one-on-one situation with Estupiñán. Not much joy to refer, Mahrez.
Yeah. Pretty pleased with the first quarter now from the Albion one?
Yeah, yes. I think it's not the same intensity of football.
No, from either side. Here's Colwell chipping it up the pitch. Walker goes back there. Estupiñán goes with him. Walker wins the day. Helped out by Mahrez. Short pass into Goodwin. He loses it though, and Colwell finds Welbeck. Welbeck, edge of the box, into Ferguson. On his left side now. His width to the left, but he goes a little 1-2 with Welbeck, and it didn't work. It was a simple pass out to Estupiñán, but Welbeck's won it back. battling hard there with Alvarez. Still going. Good work by Welbeck. Matoma drags it back. McAllister looks up, shoots, drove it hard. Comes back. Caicedo. He then hits it. That's blocked. Comes back for McAllister again. 10 yards outside the box to the right. Gross. Oh, the drag back just didn't work there. Rico Lewis is fouled now by Gross. Maybe a bit of frustration. Well, he's done it three or four times already today, Pascal Gross.
Well, putting pressure on this back line of Man City there. Two block shots. I think Casido has to hit it a bit earlier, doesn't he? Mm. I believe you're going to score. McAllister didn't take a second opportunity, does he? He tried it. But Casido's thinking, am I supposed to do this?
Yeah, I mean, it's set up nicely with Casido, didn't it? Cole downward header, back into the... deep into the City half. Now it comes back with interest to Haaland. Headed forward there by Mahrez. Bernardo Silva across to the left to Palmer. Gross needs to get towards him now. Palmer coming in from the left. Curls it in and it's away by Van Hecker. Out of play for a throw.
In the end from Palmer. I think a bit of a let off there. With the right at us. Using the width, picking the second balls up.
Yeah.
Trying to get stretched the games on it, that's for sure.
Yeah, it is. I think we're certainly going to have more goal mouth action. Man City averaging three goals a game against Albion in the Premier League. Three warming up for City. Back it goes to Ortega, the keeper for City. Short pass forward to Gundogan. Gundogan up to Alvarez. Now Bernardo Silva exchanging passes there, and Gundogan gets it back once more. Zerbi gesturing back. He never switches off, does he?
Us in a little bit, aren't they?
Yeah, they're trying to do a Brighton on
the forwards are trying to make in the big area space
with Mahrez, Haaland, and Palmer. Yeah, they're quite happy to hold on to it deep inside their own half. Suck Albion in. Mind of Welbeck and Ferguson both on the pitch, sort of playing like a two. Great tactical battle as well between these two managers. There's John Stones, short pass to Gundogan, trying to take it away from McAllister. Bypasses him, now they've set the trap, now they're away. Over halfway, Rodri, dissected his two teammates. Pep Guardiola frustrated there with that pass. Understandably. Tony Bloom here today again. And, celebrations at the weekend alongside his son. Lovely ball by McAllister. Off goes Buonanotte. Offside.
Just went a little bit too early. Buonanotte didn't need to because you can see all the pitch, can't you? He plays on the shoulder. Undav's coming on now, Johnny.
Yeah,
Welbeck will be coming off.
More rotation. He's in good form, Dennis Undav. But sometimes these are difficult games to get to the pace of. Skipping and winning that. Mahrez felt it should have been a foul. It was a strong challenge, but a fair one, according to Simon Hooper. Here's McAllister. Worked it well to Estupiñán. He's got some space. Delivers the cross. Whips it in onto the chest of Mitoma. Out comes the keeper, who blocks the shot. And out it goes for a corner.
Again, I don't know why he didn't go with his left foot.
Oh, I'd go with the head. It's pinged into him at pace.
Little flick
with a head, maybe to the back post, Warren.
Oh, that goal. Just near post.
Yeah, that's what I mean, yeah. Sorry, yeah, with the head on goal to the back post. Second time he's chested it down in the box. First time it went into the back of the net, but it's disallowed for handball. Now we have a corner. Nearly 20 minutes played in the second half. BBC Radio Sussex with Premier League football for you this Wednesday evening. What a game we've witnessed so far. Gross to take the corner for the Albion. Chipping it in near post. Glancing header by Ferguson. Big leap at the back by Caicedo, but it's nodded away by City. Whether or not it goes to pick it up. They've all stayed forward. Well, they want to get a ball back in there. Colwell's still up there. So's Ferguson. And Hecker's just going to trot back to halfway just in case. Gross in possession on the left. Stayed on this side after the corner. Estupiñán slightly isolated here. Comes back to McAllister, who's just slotted into the defence. great atmosphere we've had right from the word go tonight. Certainly not after the Lord Mayor's show this evening, despite the celebrations at the weekend. And Hecker now into Welbeck. Good to see Welbeck pushing late into the game. Now Buenanotte. Good first half. In there to Caicedo. Slides it back to Colwell. Left footed. Up to Mitoma. Chests it down to get the ball under control. This is a really, well, tough afternoon. But Mahrez got the better of Caicedo. And here's Alvarez. Hoisting it high. Haaland brings it down. Shoots. It's wide. Thought there's a bit of handball in there as well.
Trying to get that goal, isn't he?
Yeah.
Pulled off the centre half very well, but
yeah, it's just outside the box, handball.
Well, I'm not too sure if he's on ball.
Yeah, here's Steele playing it up there to Ferguson. No foul. John Stones wins it fairly, says the referee. Here's Alvarez bursting down the right, checks onto his left side, pulls it back for Mahrez. Mahrez drifting into the box there. Back to Alvarez again, onto his left foot. The deflected shot is hooked clear by Estupiñán. Walker and Welbeck getting the tangle. Referee says six of one and half a dozen of the other. Buenanotte trying to win it over the far side against Cole Palmer. And he's successful. Now he's drilled it along the ground to Mitoma. Mitoma, Walker getting back into position. Mitoma thought about trying to take him on, but one of the fastest defenders in the Premier League there. He knows he's been in the game as well, Kyle Walker. McAllister again. Wide. Mitoma. Plenty of height in there now. Welbeck and Ferguson in the middle. Mahrez with the block. Goal kick. So yeah, come off Mitoma again. Just wondering whether sometimes, Warren, he could trust the cross.
Well, yeah, of course you can. You got players in the box. I mean, height in the box, movement in the box. There's a corridors there. Say, defenders hate defending running towards the own goal.
Also, Warren, if you cross a couple of times, they're not sure whether you're going to cross or then go again. It puts doubt in the mind of the defender, perhaps.
Yeah, of course. But we don't do it often enough, do we?
No.
Sometimes we're trying to score the perfect goal.
We'll take it with the goal kick. Picking out Haaland. He heads it wide to Palmer. Gross is in there with a challenge. I wouldn't be surprised if Joel Veltman comes on at some stage in the latter point of this second half. Still a quarter of the game to go. Albion 1, Manchester City 1. Steele with the ball on the edge of the D. Both teams have gone for it today, that is for sure. Up it goes to Ferguson. Now McAllister finding Mitoma. Oh, over the top of the head of Ferguson. I think he didn't think it was meant for him. Mitoma comes back, commits the foul free kick. Not a bad foul, that.
Yeah, he had to do it, didn't he? Estupiñán made a run beyond. He's got back, though, but still, it's dangerous, isn't it?
Here's Gundogan, 10 yards inside the Albion half. Walker now, tackling on the right, pings it into Alvarez. Back to the captain, Gundogan. Not sure about his future, where it will lie, but what a talent he is. Pops up with goals as well. Trying to orchestrate something as he drifts to the left-hand side of the midfield. Bernardo Silva now, 3 yards from the left touchline, midway through the Albion half. Forced back in field, Rodri. Checks. Back again. Cross halfway to Kyle Walker. Good charging down there by Mitoma. Out for a throw. Adam Webster's now warming up for the Albion. Well, there's a bit of a delay here. Eventually the ball will be returned to City. Go forward to Alvarez. Alvarez away from Mitoma now. He's players may start to tire because I know they're fit, but it's been a very intense fixture. It's tied at 1-1. Bernardo Silva now. Cannot switch off against City, that's the key. That's when they're so dangerous. Here's Gundogan, probing down the left. Lays it off to Palmer.
That's what they'll do, they'll try to run you into the ground, Johnny, and switch. One person switches off, and then get in at you. at the moment, pressing very well over the pitch. Togetherness.
Turned there by Rico Lewis. And he's got past Brennan Otte too easily as well. Into the middle, Alvarez. Tackled by Caicedo. Just to be a foul there.
I think Caicedo had to do that really, because two weak passive goals in the challenge. And Brennan Otte in the challenge. Rico Lewis just took it away from him. And there, Caicedo has to make a challenge when he need to stop the play.
There's a free kick midway through the Albion half. And kicked across there by Pep Guardiola. Shakes hands with Roberto De Zerbi. As well with Graham Scott, that would have a laugh and a joke. Albion won't be laughing or joking if something happens from this free kick, though.
Better play a bit now, so.
Mahrez chipping it in, good header by Van Hecker. Otherwise, it would have sailed through to Haaland, who would have been unmarked. Matoma trying to get through a sea of red and black. No blue moon for Manchester City this evening. They're in their change strip, and it goes back to the keeper, Ortega. Short pass to Walker. Now Rodri. Across to the left-hand side to Alvarez. Rico Lewis. From well in that flexible left-back role. Zinchenko used to play it at times, didn't he? And he goes back now. Ortega once more. Veltman and Ndava both warming up now for the Seagulls. So, could be changes three and four. Lewis nearly caught in possession there by Facundo Buonanotte. He's had a really good game for the Albion. He's frustrated that he wasn't going to be involved with Argentina's under-20s in that tournament, but what a role he's played this evening at the end of this Premier League campaign. Taken now. Bernardo Silva making his 200th Premier League appearance this evening, the third Portuguese player to do so. What a player he is. And the ball now, taking it away from the Argentinian McAllister and back to his keeper. Oh, playing it a little bit like Brighton at the moment, knocking it around at the back. Ortega once more, onto his left foot this time, sending it to the touchline. Palmer brings it down on his chest. A short pass to Rico Lewis. Now they might spring into action here, City. Lewis, good stop there by Matoma, twice. McAllister trying to help him out, but City come forward. Gundogan exchanging passes with Alvarez. Van Hecker goes down. No foul there. He's holding his shin. Van Hecker. Long range shot. Just over the bar.
I think it's kicked him off the ball.
I think he's holding his right shin. Jan-Paul Van Hecker. Not happy with that.
Because he was grabbing him.
We might be able to get some sort of... I couldn't really see from that sort of distance. We might need a... Oh, there's a little bit of a left foot in there, isn't there, afterwards? It's a little wince there from Jan-Paul Van Hecker. So, Facundo Buonanotte is going to come off. Make of it is probably the most positive performance we've seen from him in an attacking force.
Yeah, he's put his City on, hasn't he? Especially the first half, not probably not had much of the ball second half. But that's our first half, that's our glimpse of what he can do. And Danny Welbeck, we've seen it all from Danny Welbeck tonight, haven't we? Missed kicks, missed headers, hit the crossbar, scored, great finish, disallowed, but.
Yeah, he's looked very sharp, hasn't he?
Worked very hard.
So, Veltman on. Roberto De Zerbi saying he will be with us next season. Quite sure. I asked him about the details of that contract, but he said, I don't know the details, but he will be with us 100%. There's Gundogan from deep, for City. So, 15 minutes plus added on time remaining. Still Albion 1, City 1. Forward by Ortega. Veltman, first touch. Cushion header to Gross. On to McAllister. up there to Mitoma, centrally positioned. Undav, way down the left channel, dinks it back post, oh, it's just over the top of Ferguson, picked up by Gross, right side of the box. Rico Lewis going with him. Here's Veltman, sends in the cross, it's deflected back towards the edge of the area, away by Bernardo Silva, got there before Ferguson. Opened up there for Dennis Undav. Veltman into Ferguson, lovely, chests it down, trying to bring it down onto his left foot. Comes back, hit by Estupiñán, oh, what a strike! Just wide.
I tell you what, Estupiñán's getting closer, isn't he?
Well, we've already had one wonderful goal from Julio Enciso from distance, and that wasn't far wide. It bounced a couple of times and then he hit it forcefully and it just skimmed away. And there you can hear the replay's just been played. Didn't quite hit the post, I don't think. But here's Albion with Mitoma. Mitoma trying to flick it back towards Undav, but it's away by Gundogan. Colwell goes down with Alvarez. Albion free kick.
It's a right free kick as well, isn't it?
Albion just pushing at the moment. McAllister across there to the right to Van Hecker on halfway, swept back to the keeper Steele by Veltman. Another long conversation with the backroom staff there. Roberto De Zerbi maybe saying that he may be making another change soon. Sometimes you just need one up, one in your locker, don't you, just in case there's an injury or something. Steele to Ferguson, bounced firmly off his chest there, brought down by Gundogan, free kick. Well, the one thing about Ferguson, if he doesn't go for you, he just keeps going though, doesn't he, Warren?
Yeah, he'll just take another knock. I can't believe it's like 18.
Big June coming up for him with the Republic of Ireland, Warren.
Yeah.
Oh, first, yes. First of all, he needs to get Albion over the line and into the Europa League. As it stands at the moment, that will be Albion's destiny. A draw for which is on September the 1st, but a point tonight would guarantee it. Here's Steele taking his time, now he chips it to Estupiñán, header into the middle. I say that goes to meet it, but Stones is there first. He then gets it back into that midfield area. Undav has to work a bit harder, maybe he's going to have to do a fair bit of defending as well as trying to give Albion a threat in attack. Now Cole Palmer over on the left, up against Veltman. Jinking little run, waiting, rolls it back. Here's Rico Lewis, little short pass to Gundogan. Albion just backing off there, it goes back to Palmer. Palmer waiting to deliver the cross, floated in. Haaland, close range! He doesn't miss from there. That's even closer than the one in the first 5 minutes. And City restore their lead with 12 minutes remaining. Erling Haaland, the Premier League's top scorer. His 37th goal in this division gives City the lead once again.
Yeah, Veltman just stood off Palmer, didn't he? I know he didn't just come on Veltman, but he just stood off him, give him a yard or two. And they just stopped him. Stopped Veltman, went again, stopped him, went again. And it's a lovely cross. Veltman has to get tighter. Not tight enough. But what a cross that is. I think Corwell has to do better as well.
I think he felt that Haaland was holding his shirt, but in the end, he's 3 yards away from him. Mm. Is there going to be a check?
No, check?
Don't think so. I'm just wondering here that Simon Hooper being advised to come to the near side.
Maybe. Well, you're not going to...
He sort of just... He just... Well, certainly Levi Colwell was protesting. Simon Hooper advised by Chris Kavanagh to come. Yeah, he does pull his shirt, doesn't he?
Disallow goal, is it?
There's a clear tug there on the shirt. The goal, I think, is chalked off. Haaland's frustrated, but he clearly dragged back the shirt of Levi Colwell in the build-up to the header. It won't count. We're back to 1-1.
Yeah, it's a great spot. Haaland doesn't need to do that, but he's done it. But Colwell, right, it's always protested.
Well, I'm thinking back to the Etihad, Warren. Haaland up against Webster.
Do you remember that? And people thought that was a foul. Maybe there's a bit of justice there as Steele plays it short to McAllister, onto Caicedo, up over halfway, driving up the pitch, straight down the middle, lays it off, Gross on the right, he dinks it back in, three queuing up, and Thomas header goes over, goal kick, still 1-1.
Great bit of skill from McAllister, give it into Corwell, right, sorry not Corwell, Caicedo, driven 50, 60 yards, backing off, and I think pull the trigger, but no, he puts it wide, Pascal goes, puts it up, back post, Atoma, not his strongest point heading, is it?
Pep Guardiola protesting with the fourth official and Andrea Maldera. I think he's saying it's not a foul, Chris Kavanagh, just about the most popular person this evening for Albion fans. I think he did the right thing. He said to Simon Hooper, go and have a look. And he said it very quickly. Well, it's bounced off McAllister back to Steele. Didn't want to make a mistake in defence. And he had that little reprieve up to Undav. Nice cushion layoff to Caicedo again. Can he take it up the pitch? Uses McAllister, urging him forward. He's over halfway. Four up with him. Slides it in. Undav's first touch is a poor one. Out comes Ortega.
It's caught off his shin, isn't it? I think a bit worried now. Pep saying calm down, kick it out of play.
Yeah, they're trying to make a change, aren't they?
Stones is down.
They just pulled back the fourth official there. The board has fallen out of its casing.
I think Stones has gone down injured.
Well, this will be a concern with two huge cup finals to come, and that's why he's saying get the ball out.
Phillips will come on, won't he?
Well, Caicedo reluctantly didn't want to shoot. He laid it off. Tomo with that header there. Soon you're going to have to start thinking your player of the season, Warren. Of course, Albion Unlimited back for the final time next Tuesday night. Of course, available as a podcast as well. We'll be reviewing the season. Yellow card for Pep Guardiola. I don't want you to reveal it now, Warren. I just want you to think about it. I'm sure you have been thinking about it.
Yeah, I've done it.
Done it.
All done and dusted.
Oh, okay, top three then. That'll give you something to do over the next few days.
Don't the top three now?
No, I don't want it now. We'll ask the fans, shall we? In the build-up to the final game and the final Albion Unlimited podcast. Available on BBC Sounds. Here come the changes. Sergio Gomez and Calvin Phillips are coming on. Phillips also named in that England squad today. Stones coming off. I think he's just explaining there to Guardiola what the problem is.
I think he relies a lot on John Stones, doesn't he?
Well, he sort of slotted him into midfield at times, hasn't he? There's no Diaz, no Laporte tonight. Loads and loads of youngsters. They have a game on Sunday. We have a game on Sunday. Join us from 4 p.m. live on BBC Radio Sussex for the final game. A trip to Aston Villa. That's the final day for the Seagulls. Rico Lewis out of play, but it's a foul by Mitoma. Clumsy. And it will be a free kick. Manchester City go to Brentford. That's not an easy game either. It's quite nice when all the games kick off at the same time. Here's Walker taking it away from Undav. Now Ortega, the goalkeeper, sending it high towards Haaland on halfway. Cole was underneath it, puts it backwards though. Belton's ball was a poor one and it worked out okay there. Calvin Phillips not quite got to the pace of the game there. Brentford, of course, can chase down both Spurs and Villa. Really been in the conversation, have they? But what a season they've had, as have Fulham. And what a season Albion are having. Can they get the icing on the cake and a victory against the champions tonight? Who knows? It's tied at 1-1. We've still got another 5 minutes to be played, but City are always dangerous on the break. That's gone out of play. It'll be a throw. City pushing up the pitch now. Zerbi saying to Undav, get back. And that's been a feature. Both Ferguson and Welbeck have had to defend, Warren, and Undav's got to do that as well.
Yeah, he has to defend from the front. that's the most important. If you're going to play this way, you have to defend from the front and all go together. No point going in ones and twos. That's when you get picked off.
There's Rodri, across to the left-hand side. Gomez, getting a little bit of pace forward there. Also, if you want a marker for Europe next season, these Premier League games against top five really are very good and very useful. Oh, Mitoma losing out there. Rico Lewis got past him very easily, and he's got Mahrez on the outside. Across comes Estupiñán, and he wins the throw as well. Brilliant defending. Strong challenge. We've only had three losses against top five. Arsenal, Man City and Newcastle, the three defeats. There's Colwell trying to ping it up there to Ferguson. As if he didn't like that, wanted to maintain possession, quite rightly. 4 minutes of normal time remaining. Tied at 1-1. Alvarez can't get away from Estupiñán. Roll forward there by Caicedo, though, to McAllister. Now Dennis Undav. He tried an intricate ball through the middle. Just a simple pass on there to keep possession for another few minutes and work your way up the pitch.
I think there's lots of grass over the top, though, isn't it? A little chip over the top.
Another option. He's trying to be positive, Dennis Undav. Pounce. Oh, that's a terrible challenge on McAllister there by Phillips. Oof. Is he going to go? No yellow card there from Simon Hooper.
Trying to pull out of the
tackle. Yeah, I think he did. He already had his left hand up in the air, and I think that's probably what saved him there. So 3 minutes left of normal time. Albion 1, Manchester City 1. Final home game of the season. What a game we've had. Undav back to McAllister, up now to Ferguson, trying to angle it back across, and Gomez gets in there and plays it back to Ortega. Ortega floating it forward. Mahrez on his chest, takes it away from McAllister. Free kick fouled by the Argentinian. City will have a chance to take that from inside their own half. One more change maybe coming potentially.
As always, thank you for your amazing support.
31,388 to witness this game. What a game we've had. Don't forget, you can contact us 81333, start your message with the word radio, or tweet us on at BBC Sussex Sport if you want to join the conversation. Still a little bit of football to be played though. Here's Kyle Walker, Undav, going strongly. I wonder whether he could have just committed the foul then, break up play. He needs to get back into position because Cole Palmer's trying to take on his man. Beltman does bring his man down and he gets a yellow card.
Beltman don't need to dive in there, does he? He just has to hold him up.
Yeah. I think he just quick runs defeat into him, to be honest.
It's defeat.
Shake of the head there now by Beltman. Well, here's the free kick, 8 yards in from the left side. Midway through the Albion half, big angle for maybe Mahrez to swing one in. Few options. Haaland's on the edge of the box. Phillips is in there too. Rodri's come forward. Mahrez left-footed with pace. Haaland's underneath it and it scoops up and over the bar.
Whip ball in. Just gets two in front of it, doesn't he? Behind him, he can't get it.
Julio Enciso gets player of the match, Warren.
55 minutes. Not for his goal. A bit embarrassed. Probably he's embarrassed, isn't he?
He looks a little bit sheepish down there. Goal kick for the Albion. Colwell takes it to Steele. Steele now lofting it up there towards Undav. Undav glancing header. Ferguson wasn't really alert to that one, and Walker turns it back to his keeper. Ortega goes forward to Haaland. Haaland laying enough there. Just getting caught up there with Jan-Paul van Hekker. Be a free kick in there for City, just inside the Albion half. Van Hekker, who's battled hard this evening.
He's had a good game.
To halfway. Here's Gundogan. Cross halfway to Lewis. 4 minutes to be added on. Mahrez in possession. Powers it into the middle. In there goes Van Hekker again. Gross. Up to Ferguson. Ferguson away to his left. Looks up. Lays it in for the path of Estupiñán. charging towards the box. Oh, he tried to hit it with his right foot and scuffed it completely. Now he needs to get back into position. Oh, they're given away there by Gundogan. Mitoma needed a shout of man on. Gundogan came back. It wasn't a foul. Cleared up the pitch. Haaland trying to take on Van Hecker. Van Hecker makes the challenge, gets the yellow card.
He's taking that for the team, hasn't he? Again, great strength.
I think Mitoma should have...
Mitoma, yeah, he has to do better. Maybe he likes the days, but...
So, Veltman and Van Hecker both go into the box. Not sure his manager will be too worried at this late stage in the game. So, 1 minute played and the four to be added on. Here's Gomez. He's sent to circle. Left footed back to Lewis. Lewis using Walker. Walker has to turn. Ferguson working hard, making him go back to the keeper. Gundogan picks it up. Off Ortega. Still looking for some options. Now he has to go back to his keeper again. Good structure again from the Seagulls. We've seen that a lot tonight, I think. Yeah. Good organisation when they've lost the ball. I think they've got back into position really well.
If you look, Johnny, though, it's three against three, though. They're playing Brighton. Still high-intense football, isn't it? Trying to squeeze them in there.
Well, they have had the ball in the back of the net, so you need to be careful. And here's Mahrez. Stupinian got sucked in there slightly, and Mahrez releasing it into the middle. Calvin Phillips in the centre circle, over halfway, from right to left it goes. Gomez along the ground to Palmer. Palmer up against Veltman, already on a yellow card. Palmer still going. Gross trying to help out. Goes back to Gomez. He sends it in to the back post. Big shout by Steele to let it go, and it's out for a goal kick. 2 minutes left of injury time remaining.
Yeah. Can't be angling there. Can't get that point.
What a valuable point it would be. Just the one win against Manchester City in the Premier League. They don't come very often. This is an excellent side, and Albion are an excellent side. Again, the goal kick taken by Colwell to Steele. Steele again, chipping it straight up the pitch. Comes off Ferguson, rebounding off Walker. Trying to get it back. McAllister sniping at the heels there of Gundogan, forcing City back. Gomez, trying to beat the press. Little 1-2 with Phillips. He's off on his way. Albion with players up the pitch. Need to get back their shape once more. To the final stages here at the Amex. One apiece, Gundogan weaving his way forward, squares it, calls for a shot, but Mitoma's in there quickly. Now Ferguson, nice turn, Undav back to Mitoma. Mitoma's off and running. Undav in the middle, must stay onside, curled to the back post. Ferguson gets there, but he's going away from goal. Turns to get to the byline, sends it back into the box. Header away by Walker. He picked up by Moises Caicedo. De Zerbi says keep it calm. McAllister on the ball. Calm as you like. Back out to the right. Veltman using Gross. Gross into Mitoma. No offside there.
Just had to win a clock run. Yeah. The ball.
Caicedo back to Van Hecker. Van Hecker across to Colwell. Maybe they can launch one more attack. We shall see. Colwell just inviting City forward. Ferguson. Back to McAllister. Full time. Brighton and Hove Albion 1, Manchester City 1. The Seagulls are heading to the Europa League. They have the point they needed, and they've done it against the champions.
Now, can go and have a little relax. The manager's in the little room they go to and have a drink and celebrate. City being champions and Brighton getting the Europa League. Absolutely brilliant. So I go head to head with Man City and have probably the better chances. It's a wonderful, wonderful day for Brighton Football Club.
What a game as well, Warren. You've got to hand it, this team is Manchester City. They're brilliant, but Albion were brilliant tonight. Two teams going at it, hammer and tongs, back and forward. I mean, it could have been 5-5, couldn't it?
Yeah, it could have been 5-5, but Johnny, that first half was sensational, wasn't it? Great football was played. Second half was a bit stop-start, but still chances at both ends. Absolutely wonderful football, and two wonderful football sides, and I can't wait now for Sunday.
I can't wait for next season, John.
Absolutely, plenty to look forward to. Albion will be playing in the Europa League next season. Get the date in the diary, September the 1st. That's the draw, the first game, 21st of September. All that to come, but we've got another fixture. We've got reaction to come as well. Your player of the match, Warren, tonight.
Player of the match. I think it's one of the centre-halves. I think Van Ecker or Colwill, one of them. I'm going to go with Colwill.
Okay. Yeah. They were both very, very good indeed. And we've got to talk about that goal, haven't we? Julio and Enciso.
Yeah. He's got the man of the match because of that goal. That's what he's done it for. He did play well for a start. But you can't play 55 minutes and get man of the match, can you? Truly. Well, I think Van Ecker and Colwill did a good job on Haaland. What do you think? He scored a goal, but he had to cheat to score it with his field sub and his shirt. I thought they marshaled him well. When they had to give a free kick away, they did. Very good. I'm just delighted we got that point before we go on Sunday. The pressure's off now.
A few players came in, the likes of Buenanotte as well. He made changes, but they put up their hands and said, I want to be a part of it, haven't they? I mean, I know they'll look to strengthen in the summer, but saying that, these players on the fringes of the team want to be involved.
Yeah, of course they do. And that's what you think when you call upon, you have to be ready. And they were. Buenanotte played very well. First half. It's just Steele did very well, if you think. The goal started from Steele, didn't he, playing in? But it's just an all-round team performance.
I actually thought Steele was maybe a candidate for man of the match as well. He made three very crucial saves.
Yeah, he did. Not looking for that, but yeah, he's just a Estupian. He had a good game. Casino had a good game. I think Welbeck, first half. It was a good game all around, a good game of football, Johnny. I enjoyed it. It was for these fans to watch this type of football, they must be dreaming.
Well, I looked in the programme notes this evening, Warren, and there's, you know, the usual, obviously, notes you get in the introduction from the manager, from the CEO, but there was also a note from Tony Bloom today at the end of the season. Quote unquote, we are undoubtedly watching the best Albion team we have ever had, and it gives me such pleasure to make that statement. Yeah. Hear, hear.
Well, yeah. It is the best ever side. But like I say, every manager before De Zerbi has set, put little footings in there, hasn't it? It's not just De Zerbi, it's the little footings what was done before that. And the football has been played. You can go back to Cus Poyet. He started the football. We played, wanted to play football. And it just grew and grew. Graham Potter took it to another level. And now this guy's taking it to another level. So, whoever the next manager comes in, whenever he does, he's got...
Well, here comes the light show. Albion doing another lap of appreciation out on the pitch. Now it's over to you. Get your texts, get your tweets, get your WhatsApps in. An incredible night. Albion have the point they needed, and they're heading to the Europa League. Full time here at the Amex. Brighton and Hove Albion 1, champions Manchester City 1.
Thanks very much indeed. I think we'll just let the atmosphere speak to itself as the Albion players make their way around the pitch here at the Amex. Magnificent atmosphere here at the Amex Stadium. All the supporters of the North Stand standing. The players making their way around the pitch. Manchester City players have gone down the tunnel. I noticed Pep Guardiola shaking hands with every Brighton player. It really was a tremendous game of football. A real credit to both sides. Billy Gilmore just shaking hands with one of the television crews down on the side of the pitch. Moises Caicedo looks like he doesn't want to leave the pitch. He's just standing down below us. Boy, another critical era, so what a great atmosphere. And what a great atmosphere for the Premier League.
I could hear you now to answer the question, but I can't hear you. So.
We'll just let the players make their way around the pitch, and then we'll speak to Warren in a few moments' time. It really is booming loud here at the Amex Stadium, and the players are making their way in front of the tunnel here. We'll be right back.
and in front of the tunnel, all the backroom staff are there. Jean-Paul Van Hecke making his way down the tunnel, followed by Caro Matoma, Alexis McAllister, Moises Caicedo. I just wonder whether we're going to see the likes of McAllister here at the Amex again. He's making his way down the tunnel. There he goes. Alexis McAllister signing a shirt down in the tunnel, literally down in front of us. Joel Beltman, Dennis Lundo, Levi Colwell. There goes Alexis McAllister down below us. What a great night it's been at the Amex. And just in the back, Lewis Dunk, the skipper, Jason Steele, giving the kit man a hug as he makes his way down the tunnel. And just as it was on Sunday, I should say. Strains of Sweet Caroline. Another memorable night at the Amex Stadium. Let's just leave it to the fans. So, I think we can begin to hear ourselves sing here. Warren, what a game of football that was. I loved every minute of it.
The first half was, like I say, was an unbelievable game of football. So watch that. Week in, week out, which we have done today, this season. It's just brilliant. And we've gone there with the champions, toe-to-toe, haven't we? If you think about the game, the chances, both ends, I think we've had more chances than they have. So just proves, if you're organised, resilient, determined, you can go toe-to-toe with the best. And that's what we need next season. We need to go in, and when we go to that Europa League, we need performances like that week in, week out, in that, especially in the group stages. Completely different when you get to the one-off games, but get through the group stages, you need games like that and to perform like that. So we set the standards now, and they have to keep reaching them.
Let's just have one more edition of Sweet Caroline as the fans make their way out of the stadium all around us here at the Amex. Flags flying. And tell you what, these fans can't wait for next season, Warren.
I'll tell you, that first away game, where we were playing in Europe, like I said, depends how big that stadium is, where we're going to go. I think there might be 10,000 Brighton fans going, whatever it is. And I just hope it's not far away, like just a Spain or a Portugal, a Lisbon. Still be hot, September. Yeah,
you can't. I was just looking at the Albion side tonight, particularly in that first half, when you think the likes of Alexis McAllister, Evan Ferguson were on the bench. And when the sides were announced, we thought Crumbs is a strong City side. But it was even Stevens in that first half, Warren, despite that side that City have gone out. It was a terrific performance.
Yeah, it is. What do you say? Yes, I don't think they were a full pelt. The intensity, what they showed against Real Madrid. But you only can do what you put in front of them. They're not going to go full pelt. They've won the league. They don't want to get injuries, but they're still competitive. And that's what you like. There were still tackles going flying in, so they didn't hold back. They want to win every game they're playing. That's what Pep's installed in them. And Pep would say, today there was probably an odd task to beat this side. And he knows the Derby. He's got lots of respect for the Derby, and vice versa. Like you say, we're moving forward, and we're moving forward at rate of knots. We need to slow down.
I noticed at the end, Warren, Pep Guardiola went around, he was shaking hands. I noticed he walked across the Brighton players, he was shaking every player's hands. People say, well, he would do that, it's the last game of the season. But I think you're right, there was a respect there, and I think, you know, there were times in that game when he was getting quite agitated on the touchline.
Yes, like I say, Pep wants to win every game. And so does Deserve, the perfectionist, these two managers. And that's why they've got great respect for each other. But I just can't. From where we've been, this football club, and to where we are now, the football.
You're quite emotional about it, Warren.
Yeah, I am, if I'm honest, because I'm a Brighton fan and I want to watch this type of football. And I've been spoiled. Because when I get home and I watch other games, I think I turn it off sometimes. I think this is rubbish. Go to the Championship game. I think what are they doing? They can't even pass straight. And that's where we've been, and this is where we are now. It's just, well, you have to pinch yourself sometimes and say, What are we? We're Brighton, only Brighton. Well, Brighton, we're in